Hi, I'm Dr. Robert Pugach, the medical director of Western States HIFU. What you're going to see today is something quite remarkable. I'm going to show you an actual HIFU procedure. We're going to go inside an operating room where we'll be doing this in a short time. Now, what you won't be seeing are some of the things that we usually associate with operating rooms. Scalpels, sutures, clamps. And the reason for that is HIFU is a completely non-invasive procedure. For patient privacy reasons, obviously we can't show you the patient, but you see, we don't have to because the procedure is done robotically. We're not actually at the patient's bedside. We're at a robotic console several feet away. What that means is everything is done via a computer, and I'll be at the keyboard making changes constantly to deliver the right amount of HIFU energy. I started doing HIFU procedures 11 years ago. In those days, we had to travel outside of the United States to do them. I got interested in HIFU because, as a surgeon, I was concerned about some of the side effects that many of my patients experienced, such as erectile dysfunction and bladder control problems. What HIFU offered was a completely non-invasive procedure that, in most patients, avoided those side effects. Now that it's here in the United States, we can offer this procedure far closer to your home at Western States HIFU. In just a few moments, you're going to see why a HIFU procedure is virtually painless. It is truly non-invasive. I'm going to show you the different parts of the machine now. The main HIFU unit is the box. The box houses the software that drives the remarkable HIFU device. Connected to the box is a computer console. It's what I use to connect with the box so I can deliver the right amount of HIFU energy to make sure your prostate is treated correctly. This is the cooling system that delivers ice-cold water to the treatment probe to make sure that your prostate doesn't get too much energy. And finally, this is the HIFU probe. It looks simple enough. But actually, what you're seeing is a ceramic transducer that rotates to the left, right, forward, and back to make sure we can treat all the different areas of your prostate. And we can do that with remarkable precision, to the point where the vast majority of patients who have a HIFU procedure have normal bladder control and normal sexual function afterwards. Now we're ready to start planning our treatment zone. And so we're going to ask the computer to take a series of 15 images that are 3 millimeters apart. And it will then allow us to start marking the areas that we're going to treat. And we're going to get 3 different views of the prostate. This is called the transverse view. We're looking at the prostate from the front to the back. This is called the sagittal view. This is the one that's the computer is now building for us. And this looks at the prostate from the back to the front. And then finally, the image that's being created over here is called the coronal view. It's sort of an angled view and a combination of these two, almost like a 3-dimensional picture of the prostate. And our computer is actually showing us the progress of the different views down here. And as soon as this is complete, with about another 30 seconds to go, we're going to start planning where we're going to be placing the HIFU beams throughout the procedure. And that really is the skill set that's most important in doing a HIFU procedure, is knowing how to place those beams. And it's something that takes a lot of cases to master, but once that knowledge is part of a HIFU practitioner, we're able to sit down and do these procedures. So we're going to start now by outlining the prostate area that we want to treat initially. We're going to start to put some marks along the screen that will roughly outline the prostate. And again, part of doing a lot of HIFU procedures is learning how to interpret these images. Once we do that, we're going to lay in some treatment areas. And every red dot is an area of HIFU treatment. This is the rough outline, and these are the other two views. We usually do most of our planning in this view here, called the sagittal or side view. And we're going to take that through the different areas. So we're going to rotate the prostate image from side to side. And you can see very nicely here the outline of the prostate area. And so we're going to treat additional areas than what we've lined up so far. So our treatment plan is now set. Now we're going to do something really important, and that is setting up tissue change monitoring. This is something that's exclusive to the sonoblade system. And
What it allows us to do is assess how much heat we get in any one area during the treatment. So we bring these gates in over here to line up those areas. And now we're going to see what the signal strength is. We want it roughly around 200. And this is at 182 right now. I'm going to bring it up just a little bit. This looks like we're ready to go. So now we're going to go to the treat-a-zone portion of the computer program, which is going to allow us to start treating. And box to the right is crucial during the next phase because this gives us all of our treatment information about how much heat the different areas are getting. It's giving us a suggested power level of 38 to start with. Every time this light is glowing, that means HIFU energy is being delivered. We've chosen a cycle of 3 seconds of heat, followed by another 3 second area of heat, followed by a 3 second cool down period. This is the tissue change monitoring that's exclusive to Sonoblade. A split fraction of a second before each HIFU beam is fired, a radio frequency beam is fired into the tissue to see whether we're getting enough heat. Once that area has been treated, a second radio frequency beam is checked to see what the tissue changes. And if there's adequate change, it's either going to be orange like this or yellow. If we don't have enough heat in there, it'll come back green or gray. Actually, gray means the computer's not sure. And so at the completion of each zone, we may go back and retreat some areas if we think there wasn't enough heat there. But for that first row, it was perfect. Now this is something called popcorn. Popcorn means we're almost boiling the tissue. It's something that was described by Dr. Uchida, who's acknowledged as the father of this technology in using it for prostate cancer in Japan. Now here's a yellow area, by the way, but that's okay. Yellow and orange mean there's enough heat going on. So if we see popcorn, we know there's a lot of heat being generated there. And as long as the popcorn stays inside the prostate, that's okay. But if it starts coming, it's still within the prostate, but if it comes out of the treatment box, that's not okay. So we'll adjust the power level here to make sure that doesn't happen. We're still inside here. We're getting a little bit of heat outside. So I'm going to drop the power level to a little bit less than what the computer is saying we need. And again, that's part of experience that comes with doing a lot of HIFU cases. Sometimes, even though the computer says one thing, you have to modify that a little bit to know just how much heat to put in here. And if we continue at this pace for this particular zone, computer says we have just over 13 minutes to go. To complete treating this zone.
A few months ago, I learned that I had prostate cancer, which was a little bit of a shock at the time. But being of an engineering background, my bias was, okay, we got a problem, let's get it fixed. And so in terms of looking at solutions, clearly one wants to check out what the various options might be. So I did a lot of research, just a lot of reading, and basically, you know, came to the conclusion or the realization that given that the diagnosis was in the early stages, I thought I would be a candidate for HIFU versus something much more dramatic and obviously irreversible. The motivation for HIFU was, number one, obviously it's the least invasive. Number two, given the diagnosis, the early stage, it seems like the right approach. And thirdly, there is the prospect, should something reoccur again in the future, there is the option of future treatment, repeat treatment with HIFU. I talked to a number of different doctors and I felt a certain empathy with Dr. Pugach, allied with his experience and reputation and success rate and all of that. So those were A, the choice of HIFU, and B, the choice of Dr. Pugach. Like all these things, anesthesia and so forth, there are certain risks associated with that. But again, the confidence in the procedure, the confidence in Dr. Pugach leads me to be fairly relaxed. What else can you do?
You've heard from one of our patients. You've seen part of a HIFU procedure. But your experience with Western States HIFU doesn't start and end with a procedure. It's much more than that. We take a very comprehensive approach to your prostate cancer, to its treatment, and follow up afterwards. We also help with a number of lifestyle issues, ranging from your activity levels to your diet. In fact, you'll have a chance to meet our wonderful dietitian. We also offer a support group so you can talk to other men who have been treated for prostate cancer. They can help answer many of the questions you probably already have. I hope you found this video helpful. We look forward to offering our years of experience and welcoming you to Western States HIFU in the near future.